Hello, I'm Joseph Cornell. I'm the author of Sharing Nature with Children and Sharing Nature and many other nature awareness books. When I first began in the field, I was a young man of 20 years old, and I wanted to share the joy of nature with people. And at that time, most nature education was more reason-based and more mental. And I wanted people to be more fully engaged and to have a profound experience, to feel like they are an actual part of nature. And I found through play that people could have immersive experience and where they would forget themselves, lose themselves, and actually enter into a tree or a summer meadow. And I saw as people became alive, nature for them became alive. Some of the qualities of play are just as I was mentioning, being totally absorbed in what you're doing, a sense of self-forgetfulness, a timelessness. And there's so many beautiful qualities of play that are so instructive for having a profound experience and also have a more of a deeper education and knowing of a particular subject. And in 1979, I wrote my first book, Sharing Nature with Children. And immediately, I started receiving invitations all over the world to teach about this book. A prominent nature education organization said it started a worldwide revolution in nature education. It's been printed in over 20 foreign languages, and millions of people have connected to nature through the playful games in this book. And this has been an approach that we've always used in sharing nature. It's become a movement now all over the world. In Japan alone, over 40,000 people have taken our 3-day training course. And so play being so central, I became quite excited about reading about the current studies on animal play, human play, and brain studies, and it added a depth of fuller understanding of play. I intuitively understood its importance as a young man because I didn't want people just kind of staring there blank-faced, but I want them to enter wholly into the experience. And I found that play enabled people to do that. And there's more than just children's play. There's adult play where, you know, actually many Nobel-winning scientists, they attribute their success and their discoveries through deep play, of entering into the heart of the subject of their play through visualization, movement, empathy, all these different forms. You know, Einstein, who was quite a creative fellow, he said that he would discover things first through intuition, through play, and he'd get so immersed in his violin or playing the piano that all of a sudden he'd be on in an intuitive flow through this profound play, and then he'd say, "Oh, I got it, I got it," and then he would have the answer that he'd been seeking. And what sharing nature does is it helps people to get into an intuitive flow with nature, where they can have a profound experience. What is another word for intuition? It's calm feeling. And people become more like a mirror, where they reflect the natural environment all around them and really experience it clearly. When we just use the intellect, we're talking about nature. We're trying to describe an experience, and that's very helpful, and it adds to our understanding, but it doesn't have the power. Einstein said that he would work through his intuition, through play, and his thought experiments, and then he would use logic as a second step in order to explain what he had felt. But it was that profound experience that created the motivation. And what we found through sharing nature and the activities and using them all over the world in over 30 countries, myself personally, but we have other leaders that have added to that total. What we found is that through play, It's really the generator. We become highly motivated and feel a sense of profound communion and a knowing and understanding of an aspect of nature. And that's when a lifelong interest really develops. And that's so important if we're teaching a young child, because if we teach the facts and information, it'll touch some children, but not all the children. But when every child, every adult, every teenager can have a profound experience where they really feel a sense of belonging and a sense of relationship with something that really thrills them to their core, well, then you have a lifelong advocate, somebody who's going to continue growing and in their understanding and appreciation of nature. And so, after hearing about these new studies on play with animals, I thought it was a time to take a second look at sharing nature and to convey in a book some of these new thoughts, these new discoveries, and really tell the secret behind sharing nature and its success and why it touches so many people and has started a worldwide movement. And so in my book, Deep Nature Play, this will be available in early February 2018. And it talks about the different principles of deep play. How does deep play differ from a regular play? Well, play, as I said, is immersive, but deep play has there's a quality of full immersion in the experience where a diminished sense of self, where you're just in the experience, in the focus of your play. And if your focus is playing with a tree or some other aspect of nature, you really have a feeling of oneness with it because your thinking self is not there, but your heart self is there, where you're just in touch with that aspect of nature. And then there's so many stories of how people have had that, how that's been a life-changing experience for them. And so this book offers a new learning process and theory, really, on how to have a more profound experience through experiential methods and through intuition. And of course, it can be for any subject. I focus more on activities with nature. That's been a lifelong passion of mine, trying to help other people feel the joy of nature. But this book has many stories that of our working with people with the sharing nature activities, and just stories about creativity and how to have a more an intuitive, immersive experience with a subject, and it's how to turn through flow learning, our teaching process, how to turn play into deep play. And so it's quite an amazing book, if I may say so myself. And the book has already been published in Taiwan, in complex Chinese, and we've been sharing these principles in Asia the last several years, and in programs here at Ananda Village in Northern California. And people have been thrilled by these concepts because it gives us a greater sense of what we're doing and how to include those elements, and the importance of including a more profound experience through play in any subject that you're teaching, or just any experience that you're wanting to have. And so this book is, of course, for educators, but it's also for the adult who wants to bring more play and more meaning in their lives, and also for parents who want to have their child retain their sense of innate curiosity and sense of wonder, so that it doesn't disappear at age 5 or 6, but remains with them through life. All the great people, inventors, artists, people who have really contributed something unique in their field of expertise, they have done it through play. And it's a different kind of play than the child, 4 years old play, but not really, because a child's totally in the experience and they're using their imagination And all that exists is that experience. And somebody who has been a scientist, they play in their laboratory, the good ones do, and they see things that no one else does. And it's bringing in our native qualities of curiosity, imagination, just being totally focused on what we're doing, being in the present moment. All these different qualities help us to really gain a deeper understanding of our subject. And it's not just a mental understanding by any means, but it's an understanding that touches our whole being. So again, the book will be released in early February, and it will be available on Amazon.